Hello, it's Michael from Red Chair Diaries with our Daily Febs, Movie 1. Day the Earth Stood Still remake, 2008/2009, Keanu Reeves. Oscar winner Jennifer Connelly. Upside Down. That's the Blu-ray. There's the digital copy. And there's the original 1951. What can I say about this movie? Actually, it's another one of those movies that falls into the category of being better than I anticipated because of the bad reviews. It moved along at a pretty good pace, but it doesn't have the emotional payback and tonality of the original. I'm not quite sure what the movie maker's intention was. I mean, to do an update with some more special effects and all of that sort of stuff. But they made it into a Armageddon movie, basically. The end of the Earth was imminent because of this, the visitor played by Keanu Reeves and his planet, wherever it comes from. I mean, there's never any exposition explaining that sort of thing, really. But it was very, very odd in the fact that why did they show up if they didn't feel that anybody made any sense down here and that there was no hope for us? Why did they show up at all? I wasn't quite clear on, that narrative point. And, don't want to compare every movie, to its predecessors, because it can be unfair, different times. So this one was intended for an audience that is eating popcorn Saturday afternoon or Friday night. The guy's trying to cop a feel with the girlfriends. That's what it's for. It's not meant to tax your intelligence. So you have by-the-book performances such as Kathy Bates as, say, the Minister of, and Canada would be the Minister of Defense and the State Secretary of Defense, and not listening to reason and, basically let's bomb them, that sort of thing, or get the robot and all this. So there was all kinds of strange script issues with this. It's like it didn't make a lot of sense. And to throw in Jaden Smith as, say, the stepson of Jennifer Connelly, like, what? Hello, what was the point? Oh, hello, Rufus. So all he managed to do was be incredibly annoying. I find him very, very annoying as a child actor so far, anyway. There's a smugness there that, you shouldn't be born with, you get from your parents, I don't know, Will Smith and Jada Pinkett Smith. But he's got great hair, though. And so that was just a case of having the kid in the way, just to have this whole thing about the father dying, in the war, I'm not quite sure. Yeah, he was buried supposedly at a place like Arlington or whatever. And then the spaceship decides it lands in Central Park as opposed to Washington. So you end up with Central Park, New York, but you have like nobody there, basically. Very few people being blown around by the turbulent wind of the landing. And you have, you don't see this big panic in the streets that I can remember or anything like that. People seem to be pretty copacetic about this invasion. I mean, where were they going to go? pretty hard to evacuate New York. So I didn't quite get all of the story. I guess was an environmental story. as opposed to a Cold War story, because the original, of course, is playing into Cold War tensions. You know, it's because it was only 6 years after World War II ended when that one was made. It was made the year I was born. That's why my party last month was, in December was, in December was called The Day the Earth Stood Still. That was the theme of my my party. Because of these two monumental events arriving at the same time in 1951, that movie and my birth. And you can make of that what you will. Keanu Reeves, you know, like I think he's perfectly cast as this character who is trying to reflect what he sees as opposed to have a personality. He starts off as like an embryo or some kind of unformed alien in this. Michael Rennie just walked down the spaceship ramp looking fantastic, you know, and with so much gravitas. And then you have Keanu Reeves, and you really did expect him to try to find out where, you know, either Patrick Swayze was so he could go skydiving and surfing, or where Hugo Weaving was so that he could go fight Mr. Smith. So it was an odd sort of performance, but at the same time, it did serve the story well as it was written, which was underwritten, and Keanu Reeves is very good at conveying vacancy. And that's what he had to play with as far as I was concerned in this movie. Jennifer Connelly could have been played by any actress without any career accolades. She brought nothing to the movie that anybody else couldn't have done. Same with Kathy Bates. They could have changed her in the middle of the movie, and it could have been Fred Dalton Thompson, and you'd never notice, or Chris Cooper. I mean, it's that sort of role. You never saw the president or the vice president at all. They were in hiding, it seemed. And a lot of people got killed in this movie compared to the first one. I mean, these soldiers seem to be killed at random. I mean, helicopters just colliding and things like this. It was all, I found it was all kind of odd. I thought the special effects were okay. They weren't spectacular. New York looked pretty fake, you know. The Central Park scenes. And I thought this movie was actually made in Vancouver, and I couldn't find any sign, any indication of that at the back end, but I still think it was. I still think a lot of it was. I was pretty sure about that, and I thought that actually a lot of the scenes were shot around Stanley Park when I was looking at the scenery, not Central Park. Actually, about two blocks from where I used to live in the 80s and early 90s. Anyway, that's about it. A meandering review for day one of my 29-day festival of movies, partly cheese fest, partly classics, a couple of masterpieces thrown in there, and some very ambiguous, equivocal movies, I'm sure, that I'll be equivocal about. But I am trying to mix it up quite a bit. So I can recommend this as it's a good watch for somebody who doesn't want to be too discerning about the movie. You know, like it isn't horrible. It just isn't very good. And there's a big difference. So I am damning it with faint praise, okay? It can't stand up to the original because that you have Patricia Neal and Cold War tensions, as I said. But anyway, that's about it. Anyway, not much of a rather inauspicious beginning to day one for our daily febs. So let's hope it picks up. This behind me, that's the movies. That's the other 28 movies right here. And then as I watch them, they'll be going over there. So the next day will be Body of Lies with Leonardo DiCaprio and Russell Crowe, and I haven't opened that one. So I'm looking forward to that, seeing what that one's all about. Oh yes, I better go take this one and move it to the other side of my younger portrait next to Rufus here. Okay, we'll see you around the tube. Goodbye.